And it's better for the hill country to have a good water catching landscape. Same thing.
A group of landowners is gathered to listen to the wisdom of Steve Nelle.
Butterflies love it. They just come to it like candy.
We're here at the C.L. Browning Ranch in Blanco County, Texas, for the first of a series of field days hosted by the Hill Country Land Trust.
European settlers came and changed.
And Steve is there as somebody whose reputation is so strong that people look forward to hearing from him.
It would be a spotty, you know.
And that he's a very gentle persuader of getting in touch with that deep urge inside of yourself to be a careful steward of what you've been privileged to have.
Put it through your own test of logic and experience.
He has this gift for connecting with people wherever they are.
Even though we're trained in the technical skills of plants and animals and soil and conservation, sort of the sciences, we can do better. When we go onto farms and ranches, we're really more in the people business. If you want to recover plant diversity, leaving that cedar slash, that blanket, it's priceless.
Steve consults with landowners and natural resource professionals to provide a holistic approach to land management.
He wants people to get it, and he wants people to share what they know. He's walking the walk.
Steve has touched thousands of landowners over his career and in working with us on workshops. And the one thing that Steve does such a great job of is talking about how what we do way up in the uplands can also impact what happens down in that stream. And so he talks about where conservation begins, where that first raindrop falls.
County officials say the river rose 12 to 14 feet in just half an hour, engulfing the Blanco River and shattering a record set in 1929.
The roar was tremendous. There was just devastation. The riparian area was stripped of all vegetation.
And so the height of the flood here was, I understand you said it's over 40 feet?
With two big floods in one year, you get pretty down. And you sort of feel hopeless almost.
Lots of good grasses here. At times you just want to cry and throw up your hands and say, what's the use? Oh, and looky here, the seed head.
But he reminds you that nature is very resilient and it will recover.
Lots of little baby plants around here, lots of baby trees. Walk with a landowner across an area that's been devastated and find a few good things. And you can show them how nature's trying to recover and heal this area back up. Texas creeks and rivers, you know, they're kind of the circulatory system of the land, but they're also a way that people connect with nature. So it's a special motivation for me and others to do our very best because we feel like we're, you know, helping other people take care of God's creations.